أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، فعلمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما، وأرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه، واجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، وأدخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. The one who enable us to fast Ramadan. The one who give us the opportunity to witness Ramadan. الحمد لله. And congratulations for everyone who really fast Ramadan the way Allah wants us to fast. And congratulations for everyone who did the whole Qiyam for the whole month. And congratulations for everyone who did the Qiyam in the last 10 nights. For sure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. You will get at least one of the three opportunities which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith. Whoever fasts Ramadan for the sake of Allah, Allah will wash his sins. And whoever did the Qiyam of the whole Ramadan, Allah will wash his sins. And whoever did the Qiyam on the night of the power, Allah will wash his sins. So may Allah accept our deeds. Ameen. I know today is gonna be the last halaqa in Ramadan, but inshallah we'll continue after Ramadan every Saturday. That is our usual schedule. I'm not going to finish the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam because the story contains a lot of things to learn from Ibrahim alayhi salam. But today I will go through two incidents which is really very important incidents in the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and then we'll cap up and conclude something which we need to take with us during the coming days. So the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, after he's done from the king An-Namrud, and unfortunately no one accepted his da'wah, no one responded to Ibrahim. And you know, this giving us a good lesson that not always you will get a good hearing from the people you are calling to Allah. It's not always. Sometimes you will see some people, they are making fun of you, like the people of Ibrahim at the same time. Or sometimes they will start arguing with you just for nothing, like the king. Ana uhyi wa umit. He don't know what is the meaning of giving life or giving death, but he just argue, looking into the outer shape, is not going into the exact details and definition. So you will face so many things in doing the da'wah. But when you approach the logical approach like Ibrahim alayhi salam did, you will reach to a successful point, and maybe that fellow will respond. But you shouldn't give up. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, the only one who accepted his da'wah was his nephew, يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى فآمن له لوط. Only Prophet Lut عليه السلام, his nephew, is the only one who accepted the da'wah. And then Ibrahim lived there in the Iraq area until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to move. To move. So Allah wants him to go to Palestine. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَلُوطًا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we saved him with Lut to the holy land, which Allah blessed. This land, he blessed for all people. So Ibrahim moved with his nephew to Palestine, and then he moved north until he reached an area called Hauran, and now it is well known, Hauran. So there he settled, and then he found that the people who are there, they are worshipping the planets and the sun. Again, Ibrahim, he cannot accept these things. So he wants to try again with those people. Now you can think, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the order to move to that area? It is basically because the da'wah. He make the da'wah in Iraq at the beginning, but it was not successful. So move. So he moved. The same thing happened with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did the da'wah in Mecca. And for the whole 13 years of da'wah in Mecca, only 313 people accepted Islam. Only 300. And he tried, he met all people coming for Hajj, but no success. Then he started thinking to go outside Mecca. So the same with Ibrahim. Allah gave him order, move to Palestine. So he moved, he found those people who worship the planets and the stars. So how to convince those people that what they are doing is totally wrong? So the first thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to show Ibrahim the creation of this universe. And Allah here subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَذَلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ مَلَكُوتَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلِيَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُوقِنِينَ. So first thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to prepare Ibrahim to face those people, he needs to be educated to get more information about these planets. So the scholars, they said about the tafsir that Ibrahim alayhi salam, he has seen the universe not like what we can see. Allah make him or show him the whole universe, the whole planets and all these stars in a more detailed and more, you know, more knowledgeable way, so that Ibrahim get more faith about what is going on and about the creation of this universe. And that's why Allah here mentioned وَكَذَلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمِ. So Ibrahim was getting this lesson from Allah by seeing the whole universe as never been shown to anybody else. And keep in mind that every one of us will see a miracle or an ayah in this universe, but some people, they reflect upon it, some people do not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وهم معرضون. So many people, they see some verses or some ayat in the universe, but they do not reflect upon it. So for example, when you eat an apple, this is a very simple example. When you eat an apple, the kafir, he will see that the apple came from the farm and the farmer, he's the one who did it, so I buying it with my money. But the believer, he look into it in a different way. This is a miracle from Allah. This is an ayah. So how the believer should look? When you look to the apple, it is not only a fruit. Now you look what happens, how this apple come. When you think that the farmer, he just put a seeds in earth. So that seed, maybe it will be successful, maybe not. Right? So Allah is the one, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who make this plant to grow and then the fruit to come out. That is the difference between the believer and the non-believer. So always the believer look into everything and he looks to the hands of Allah working behind it. While the kuffar, they cannot see what is behind. They just see the front picture, but the actual one, they don't see. How many seeds they put in the floor and in the ground? Not all of them will grow. Some of them will grow. And all seeds looks like each other, but some of them will give you a different fruits, a different corpse. It all looks same, but all different matters. So what you pay for the apple is what you pay for the person who work for it. But actually, no one can bring this apple if Allah don't want it to fruit, right? So always Allah's hands are there. He's the one who make this happen. So Ibrahim, when he knows about this whole universe, now it is the time for him to argue with his people. So when becomes night, on the night time, Ibrahim alayhi salam went with his people in Hauran. So they go outside and they start searching for a god, for a star to worship. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَمَّا جَنَّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّيْلُ رَأَى كَوْكَبًا. So in the night, when he was with his people, he saw a planet shining in the sky. So he said, like what they are doing, everyone was searching, where is the God? So he saw that planet more shining. He said, oh, this is the God. He's trying now to go with them in order to make them understand that this is wrong. So he said to them, oh, this is our God. Okay, this is your God. So the people, they start worshipping that God, prostrate to that God, to that planet. So after a while, when the light started, then that planet disappeared. فَلَمَّا أَفَلَ قَالَ لَا أُحِبُّ الْآفِلِينَ. So when that planet disappeared, he said, where is my God? I need to call him. I need to make dua. I need him to listen to me. Where is he gone? I don't like the God who is not with me. So the people, they start looking to each other about what he's saying. It makes sense. Where is the God? Then on the next night, they came out together and Ibrahim went with them. So he has seen the moon. فَلَمَّا رَأَى الْقَمَرَ بَازِغًا قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي. So when he saw the moon, he said, oh, this is the God. This is bigger than the previous one. Okay, let us worship this one. So people, they start worshipping the moon. فَلَمَّا أَفَلَ قَالَ لَئِن لَمْ يَهْدِنِي رَبِّي لَأَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الضَّالِّينَ. So when the moon gone, he said, indeed, if my God didn't guide me to himself, I will be lost. Where is my God? He's gone. How can I call him? And the people, they start asking each other, what he is saying makes sense. So you see, so he start now talking with them in a logical way. So this is the approach of Ibrahim. So on the next day when the sun rises, he called the people, come, come here. You see, this bigger one, this is the God, not that planet, not the moon. This is the bigger one. Okay, let's go and worship this one. So the people, they come and they start worshiping the sun. So when it is evening, the sun gone. Again, he repeat the thing. فَلَمَّا رَأَ الشَّمْسَ بَازِغَةً قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي هَذَا أَكْبَرُ فَلَمَّا أَفَلَتْ. Now when the sun disappear, he said, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. I am innocent from what you are doing. إِنِّي. Now he will declare the truth. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. I am directing my face and my heart and worshipping the one who created all this universe and the planets and the moon and the sun. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ حَنِيفًا. Again, the word حَنِيفًا, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acknowledged that to Ibrahim, that his religion was pure, never have been interrupted with shirk. That is the faith of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and Allah declared it for Ibrahim. So inni wajjahtu wajhiya lilladhi fatara as-samawati wal ard hanifan wama ana min al-mushrikeen. I did not commit any shirk at all. That's what Ibrahim said. And then his people, especially the people who are leaders in this worshipping, they start arguing with him. وحاجه قومه قال أتحاجوني في الله وقد هدان. Now his people start arguing with him, and he was wondering, are you arguing with me with something is truth and you are making a false statement? وسع ربي كل إلا أن يشاء ربي شيئا وسع ربي كل شيء علما أفلا تتذكرون. Don't you use your mind? Allah is the one who created the whole universe. Don't you think? So he start again with them, trying to convince them to open their minds and think about what he told them about the creation of the whole universe. And then they start telling him, Ibrahim, our gods will curse you. They are going to punish you. So they start throwing some fear about the punishment of their gods, the sun and the planets, to Ibrahim. So Ibrahim said, وَكَيْفَ أَخَافُ مَا أَشْرَكْتُمْ وَلَا تَخَافُونَ أَنَّكُمْ أَشْرَكْتُمْ بِاللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ عَلَيْكُمْ سُلْطَانًا. He said, how come I will be scared or afraid from those planets, and you do not be scared that you commit a shirk to Allah, the one who created everything and created yourselves. فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. So who is the one who should feel more safe, myself or yourself? Who's the one? The one who is with the true God, with the one who created the whole universe and everything, or your side, you are with the false gods. Who deserves to feel more safe and more secured? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, he reflect, he said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Allah here give us the conclusion. Always, if you remember from the previous stories, every story which Allah is giving in the Quran, at the end, he give us the summary. what he wants us to have and to believe and to carry with us. Who deserve to be safe? The false, the people with the false da'wah or the people with the true da'wah? Allah said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Indeed, those believers. وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. And their belief does not interrupt with any kind of shirk. So their belief is pure. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ الْأَمْنُ. Those people who are deserving to have security and be safe from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are the guided people. Now, here I remind you with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. When the kuffar in the battle of Al-Ahzab, they gather all people, they gather against Islam, and it is only just few hours and Islam is gone. All people of the Arab lands, Quraysh and their supporters, all gathered around Al-Madinah. They want to get rid of Islam, to destroy Islam and kill all Muslims. It's just a few hours, then Islam will go. So, what happened? الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. So the people, they start talking to each other. Especially, you know, the hypocrites, they start spreading fear in the hearts of believers. Look, everyone is coming here to attack you, to kill you. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his response is to increase the faith of the believers. So their faith become more stronger. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا. And then the believers, they said, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Then what happened? The result? فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ. So they got, the result was a blessing and a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفَضْلٍ لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. They never been touched. لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. And وَانْقَلَبُوا بِرِضْوَانٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was pleased from the believers. This is the lesson which Allah wants us to learn from this story. Thus, we now learn how to deal with the kuffar, and also we have to build our faith to make it stronger and to believe that Allah is with us as long as we defend Islam. So what I want to take from this, it's only one word. Please Allah. This is what you want to do, to please Allah. And that is the message of Ibrahim alayhi salam. He left his home and he came to Palestine just to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second story, after a while Ibrahim get married to Sarah alayhi salam. And Allah ordered Ibrahim to go to Egypt. So again, Ibrahim, he left his home in Palestine. He left his trade. He left everything. And he obeyed Allah's rules. And he went to Egypt. And he asked Lot to go to a place called Sodom. That is the place where Lot alayhi salam was sent to make da'wah. So Ibrahim alayhi salam with his wife Sarah went to Egypt by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not by himself. So when he went to Egypt, he hear rumors that the king of Egypt at that time, he is fond of women. And if he find any beautiful woman married, he is going to kill her husband and take her for himself. So Ibrahim alayhi salam told Sarah, listen, I hear that this king is doing so and so, and by Allah, on this land there is no Muslim except me and you are my sister in Islam. So if the soldiers comes here, they want to ask about me, tell them that I am your brother. And he is her brother in Islam. We all brothers and sisters in Islam. We all. That is what Ibrahim declared. By Allah, on this land, there is no Muslim except me and you. And by Allah, you are my sister in Islam. So if the soldiers comes asking about me, tell them that I am your brother. Because if she will tell that you, I am your husband, they will kill him. So once the soldiers get the information and you won't come here, immediately they went to him. So who is that person? They ask Sarah. He's my brother. But when they look to Sarah, they found her very beautiful. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, the most beautiful woman Allah created was Hawa, Eve, our mother Hawa. She was the most beautiful woman created ever. And then the second one was Sarah alayhi salam. So when they saw her very beautiful, they took her. Now you can imagine what Ibrahim will do. And Ibrahim alayhi salam was little bit age at that time, in about his 70s. So he cannot resist the soldiers. They locked him in his house. And he was not allowed to go out. And they bought a guards. So Ibrahim, he used to do like our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing. قالت عائشة رضي الله عنها إذا حزبه أمر هرع إلى الصلاة. Means if he was worried about any matter, anything, he rush for prayer, for his prayer. So this is a teaching for us. If you are worried about anything, go and pray to Allah. Open this gate and connect with Allah. So Ibrahim alayhi salam did his prayers and start praying and making dua to Allah to save his wife. So when they got Sarah and they brought her to the palace of the king, so they put her in a room. So immediately she prayed two rak'ah. She make prayer and she said, oh Allah, listen to this dua. Listen to this dua. This dua good for all sisters. She said, oh Allah, if you know that I have believed in you and in your messenger, and I have prevent myself from doing any zina. I did not allow myself to do that. Oh Allah, protect me from this kafir. That's it. Oh Allah, if you know that I have believed in you and believe in your messenger, and I have protected myself from doing zina, oh Allah, protect me from this kafir. So the king came, when he saw her so beautiful, immediately he cannot stop himself, so he rushed to her. So when he rushed to her trying to catch her, his hand seized. He cannot move his hand, his legs freezed. He cannot move his legs. He was shocked. What happened? Then he said, release me or I am going to kill you. Then she said, oh Allah, let him go. So he was released. Then again he tried to attack her again. Oh Allah, protect me from him. He was frozen where he was. His hand paralyzed, legs frozen, cannot move. Then he said, let me go or I'm gonna call the guards to kill you. So actually she was a bit scared. He's the king and he was so tough. So she said, oh Allah, let him go. So again, the third time he tried to attack her. She said, ya Allah, protect me from him. Again, he got the same thing. Paralyzed, frozen, never move. Then he said, release me or I'm gonna kill you. She said, listen, I will not release you until you promise to let me go. Then he said, I promise to let you go. And not only that, I will give you gifts. But you let me go. Then she said, oh Allah, let him go. So Allah make him free. And then he called the guards and he told them, you brought a shaitan to me here, let her go. And he gave her a gift and he gave her a jariya called Hajar, a servant called Hajar. She took Hajar and the gifts and she returned back to Ibrahim alayhi salam. And when she come to Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim, he makes sujood shukr lillah, thanking Allah for protecting his wife. You see, when you delegate it to Allah, Allah will never let you down. When you depend on Allah, Allah will take care of you. When you have the full faith with Allah, Allah is defending you and your family and everyone belongs to you. See, these stories of Ibrahim give us the strength, give us the love to Allah. We should love Allah. Allah is the one who take care of Ibrahim, who take care of his wife, who take care of him. And he brought him from Iraq to Palestine to do the da'wah. And then he brought him from Palestine to Egypt for what? What was the reason? Think about it. What he got from Egypt? He got Hajar, our mother Hajar. Because he is going to marry Hajar later and she will bring him Ismail, our father. You see, it is the plan done by Allah. When Allah sent him there, he's not going to let him down. Allah knows what he's doing. So when you do not see why this is happening to me, why this is happening in the world, because you don't have the vision of Allah. You don't have the wisdom of Allah. Allah is managing the whole universe in his way. Whenever everything happens, it is because Allah wants it to happen. If there is any destruction here or anything going there, it is because Allah wants it to happen at this time, at that place. So don't be upset. But you say, indeed Allah has a wisdom. And I don't know about it. I don't know. But what you need? You need to strengthen your faith. You need to love Allah. You need to trust the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The final thing, I remind you with the two messages we got from Ibrahim alayhi salam. So the first message, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the authentic hadith عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, he said, Ibrahim books was totally a lot of wisdom. And the Prophet ﷺ choose for us this wisdom, the priorities which we have to take care of in our life. He said, every wise one should have control of his time during his day. And he should distribute his day into four categories. The first one is a time to call Allah and to make dua to Allah, to connect with Allah. That is the first time. The second time or the second period, it is the time you question yourself about what you did in your day, in your past day. Did you did something wrong or bad? And you should reflect and fix it. If there is something wrong, you should fix it. If it is good, you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third time, the third portion, is a time you think about the creation. You educate yourself. Unfortunately, this education is gone. Nobody likes to educate himself. They think that what we got in school is enough. But I'm telling you, what we got in school is zero. Zero. They are not teaching us anything. It is just basics. They don't know about religion. They don't know about aqidah. They are not in a position to teach you Islam as we should learn. So the third thing is learning, getting knowledge. And the fourth one is a time for your life to spend, to fix your life, to work, to feed yourself, feed your family, help your family and your children and so on. So this is the four times. And the second hadith, and then I will end up with this one. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he went to Al-Mi'raj and he reached to the seventh heaven, he found Ibrahim alayhi salam sitting beside Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. And when he asked Jibreel alayhi salam, he said, "Who is that person, Jibreel?" Jibreel alayhi salam said, "This is your father, Ibrahim." So he went to Ibrahim alayhi salam. And Ibrahim alayhi salam said, "Assalamu alayka ya Muhammad. You are the best son and the best prophet. Tell your ummah." Now this is the message from Ibrahim alayhi salam to us. "Tell your ummah assalamu alaykum." So he is sending to every one of us, "Assalamu alaykum." We should say, "Wa alayka assalam, our father Ibrahim." And tell your ummah that heaven is very beautiful, and its water is so sweet, and its ground is so fertilized, so fertilized. So what shall we do? He said, "Wagharsuha," to plant in Jannah, you need to say, "Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar." This is to plant in heaven. Four words to plant in heaven. So you want more land, you want more plants in Jannah, you do this. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. The message which we got from Ibrahim alayhi salam, he is reminding us with Jannah. Whenever you face a trouble in your life, whenever you have some calamity in your life, whenever you have some goals and you struggle to reach, remember Jannah. The Jannah is your motivation to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take Jannah as the drive to keep you going forward. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahumma ajma'na ala ma yurdik. واجعلنا من المتحابين فيك. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده معصوما، ولا تجعل منا ولا فينا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة، ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، اللهم ما قدمنا من صدقات، وما وقفنا من وقفات، من قيام وصلاة ودعاء واستجابة لك يا أرحم الراحمين، فتقبله منا على التمام والكمال، إنك أنت الكريم الرحيم. تقبل منا صالح أعمالنا، اللهم وربها لنا عندك، اللهم وزدها بركة من عندك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا رب لا تخرجنا من رمضان إلا بذنب مغفور وسعي مشكور، وقد بيضت وجوهنا وأعتقت رقابنا وبيضت صحائفنا، فلا نلقاك إلا وأنت راض عنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. يا أرحم الراحمين، ألحقنا بحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجمعنا به على حوضه الميمون وشربنا من يده الشريف فشربة لا نظمأ بعدها، إنك أنت الكريم الرحيم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك يا خير من سئل ويا أوفى من وعد أن توفي بوعدك لنا بأن تعتقنا وآباءنا وأمهاتنا وأزواجنا وأولادنا من النار يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وسلم.